heart disease is the leading cause of death in the U.S. Back in 2021, a couple years ago alone, nearly 700,000 Americans lost their lives because of cardiovascular disease.
And it's a growing problem facing a healthcare system, too. But what if there was a way that you could forecast the risks that are facing your health? For more, we welcome Dr. Grant Reed from the Cleveland Clinic. Welcome to the show.
Great
to have you here. Born and
you.
Raised, his wife's from this area, too, so it's great to talk with
you.
Welcome to our show.
Thank you for having me.
We're glad you're here. I just gave the statistic back in 2021, over 700,000 people lost their lives because of cardiovascular disease. Number one killer. So we cannot talk about it enough and talk about the guidelines and what all is being done to combat it. But in your mind, what's the number one risk factor when it comes to heart disease?
Great. Well, thanks for having me. So I'm an interventional cardiologist. So I treat patients that come in with acute heart attacks. I see them in the cath lab. I do their heart stents. But I also treat patients to help prevent that from happening and then afterwards. And there are many things that you can do to help prevent yourself from being in this situation. One of the most important risk factors is just having a heart-healthy diet. Right? We say this a lot, but the Mediterranean diet, low in saturated fats, watching your weight, heart-healthy activity and exercise. The American Heart Association recommends 150 minutes of moderate intensity exercise a week. Those are really the key ingredients. And there's a lot of other things that this report that we're discussing gets into a lot of detail about. But you're right, this is the number one killer of Americans today. It's projected to get worse by 2050. It's projected that 186 million Americans are going to have some form of heart disease.
That's like over 60% of the population.
Exactly.
I mean, that's what's so scary is this affects more than the majority, you know, I mean,
really,
truly.
Exactly.
But we live in this very convenient society right now. I mean, people are just getting food and stuff delivered to their house. No, they're not even leaving the house for it.
Yeah.
How do you, as an interventional, how do you intervene to make sure that people are doing that? And like, is it more mental? Like, you have to convince people to change their perspective?
Yeah, these are great questions. These are the questions that affect all of us, right? How do we use the experiences in our life to motivate us to make changes that are necessary to help prevent us from dying early and living a heart healthy life and being there for our kids and our grandkids, right? So, you know, we do all we can to motivate patients and present them with the information that this is what you need to do to help prevent yourself from developing heart disease, and once you have it, to use this as motivation to really make a change in your life. You know, the American Heart Association puts forth what they call life's essential eight factors. And I mentioned many of them already, with heart-healthy diet and exercise, with control of blood pressure and blood sugar, getting enough sleep, avoiding smoke, and blood pressure control and cholesterol control. These are the most important things that you can do to help prevent yourself from getting there. And our job is to present the patient with information, provide them with tools, and hopefully motivate you all so that, you know, everyone can live as long of a life as possible.
So true. And Dr. Reed, sometimes you can try as much as you want, and you can keep trying the diet and up your physical activity, and sometimes it's just in your genes that you can't.
That's very true.
So when do you turn to a doctor and say, okay, let's try cholesterol lowering medication, blood pressure, because those do help and those do save lives.
Absolutely. Those are great questions. And some other things which we didn't mention yet are family history. It's so important. And there are certain types of heart disease you're born with, but so much of this and what we're talking about today, it can be prevented in many patients, right? Right now, a little less than half of all Americans have heart disease. It's projected to go up to 60% by 2050. So there's something we can do to prevent this. And when do you seek help is important. And you have a good primary care physician that is screening you for these things. These are things that you don't need to see a cardiologist for, but once you start to develop symptoms of shortness of breath, of chest pain, of fatigue, and or if you have an abnormal test like an EKG or an echo, that's when you need to see a cardiologist, and you need to take it a step further with stress tests or other things that you can do to help prevent a heart attack from happening in the first place.
For sure.
Great information. Dr. Reed, thanks. Great to see you. Thanks for being on the show and talking about that. Good information.
Thanks so much.
Get checked, right?
Absolutely. Please do.
For sure.
You guys have a great resource, too, on your website.
We do,
with all of that too.
Yeah, the Cleveland Clinic has so many resources that you can check out online. We just have an abundance of information out there, and it's just really important that you take your health seriously. You do all you can to prevent this from happening. Pay attention to your symptoms, especially in the hot weather.
100%, you're right. Thank you, Dr. Reed. Great to see you.